morning students. So we see second stage of labor. First stage we have seen. What is first stage of labor? So it starts with the onset of two labor pains and ends with the full cervical dilatation. And second stage starts with full cervical dilatation and ends with the delivery of the baby or delivery of the fetus. And third stage starts with the delivery of the fetus baby or delivery of the fetus to delivery of the ends with the delivery of plus. So we will say nursing management of second stage of labor. So we will see very briefly what is normal labor. So series of events that takes place in the vaginal organ in an effort to expel the viable products of consumption out of the womb through the vagina into the outer world is called labor. You know very well. Then what is the second stage of labor? The second stage is that of expulsion of the fetus. It begins with cervix. Once the cervix is fully developed and the woman feels the urge to expel the baby. And it is completed when the baby is born or the baby is delivered. Next, its average duration is 2 hours in primary larvae and 30 minutes in multilarvae. It has two stages, propulsive stage and expulsive stage. Next, the clinical course takes place when the mother has pain, wearing down efforts, membrane status, descent of the fetus, vaginal signs, maternal signs and fetal ethics. So all these things have to be taken care of in case of second stage of labor. We'll see one by one. So what is the mechanism of normal labor? You know very well principles. Descent must take place throughout the labor and whichever part leaves and first meets the resistance of the pelvic floor will rotate forward until it comes under the symphysis pubis. And whatever emerges from the pelvis will pivot around the pubic bone. Okay, so these are the principal movements, important movements in case of normal labor mechanism. Next, engagement and descent, how it takes place, you can see. So how the lower pole, how the head has engaged and descending. Then parvaginal examination, you can feel posterior fontanelle and anterior fontanelle. Then, so this is syncytium and asyncytium, anterior syncytium, and this is normal syncytium and posterior syncytium. How it is, head is rotating in different positions. Next, so in flexion what happens? Posterior fontanelle becomes more evident on visualization of the introitus. Then internal rotation, during internal rotation the posterior fontanelle will be rotated from oblique to oblique diameter to AP diameter. The head rotates, internal rotation of the head. Next, extension. Through extension the phase will be delivered. Next, restitution. The neck twist that is there in the fetus, through this restitution the neck twist will be relieved and the face will be turned towards lateral side of the mother. Next, extrication of the head followed by expulsion of the trunk. So posterior fontanelle, so how first anterior shoulder will be delivered and then posterior shoulder will be delivered. Next, coming to the management. This is till up to this we have seen in mechanism of normal labor. Now we will see what are the principles of second management of second stage of labor. To assist in the natural expulsion of the fetus slowly and steadily. And to prevent perineal injuries. These two are the main objectives or main principles of management of second stage of labor. So for this, the patient should be in bed, constant supervision of the mother must be there and analgesics must be administered if the mother cannot tolerate the contractions and painful contractions, then vaginal examination. Then preparation for delivery. You have to prepare the mother for delivery of the fetus. First is the positioning. So nurse and the obstetrician scrubs up and puts on sterile gown, mask and gloves, toileting the external genitalia and inner side of the thighs, cleaning. Then one sterile sheet is placed beneath the buttocks of the patient and one over the abdomen. And sterilized leggings are to be applied to the mother. Then essential aseptic precautions are remembered, like 3 C's, they are clean hands, clean surfaces and clean cutting and ligatures of the cord. And to catheterize the bladder if it is full. If it is not full, no need for catheterization. Then conduction of delivery takes place in 3 phases. Delivery of the head, delivery of the shoulders and delivery of the trunk. First, then prevention of perineal laceration. More attention should be paid not to the perineum but to the controlled delivery of the head. And delivery by early extension is to be avoided. And spontaneous forcible delivery of the head is to be avoided. To deliver the head in between contractions, to perform timely episiotomy, to take care during delivery of the shoulders as the wider bicyclomial diameter emerges out of the introitus. See, our, when you just in case of normal labor or normal vaginal delivery, you have to provide adequate perineal support so that there is no perineal laceration. If at all it is a primary mother and you find that the introitus is very tough to for the delivery of the fetus, and the prophylactic episiotomy will be performed. This episiotomy has to be performed once, should not be done during contractions. It has to be done in between contractions. So timely episiotomy must be given. This all the primary mothers may require episiotomy, but one multi-para mothers, they may not require episiotomy unless there are the introitus is very thick and tough. Next, so episiotomy. This is a mediolateral episiotomy. Left mediolateral episiotomy will be given. So towards the left of the mother, mediolateral episiotomy will be given with operating scissors. And you can see fetal head, how the fetal head is causing bulging and vaginal opening is increasing. After mediolateral episiotomy is given. So this is midline, this is the anus. The episiotomy has to be given in mediolateral direction. Next. So what are the merits of episiotomy? The muscles are not cut by median and mediolateral episiotomy. Usually mediolateral episiotomy will be given for its advantages. So these are the merits and demerits. You can just go through. Next, immediate care of the newborn. A baby should be placed on a tray covered with clean, dry linen if the head is slightly downwards soon after delivery, and maintaining thermoregulation of the baby. See, the baby will be just coming out of the womb of the mother, and it needs some time for the adjustment to this external environment. But until the baby gets adjusted to this external environment, you need to maintain thermoregulation of the baby with a warmer. Then suctioning to clear the air passage must be done. So first suctioning of the mouth and then suctioning of the nostrils will be done, and maintaining cardiorespiratory function. Oxygen must be administered as needed until the infant cries vigorously, and you have to know for the Apgar score. And you know very well about the Apgar score. You will check for heart rate, respiratory efforts, muscle tone, reflex, irritability and color. So you will give, when all these are absent, you do 0, and if the heart rate is less than 100, slow, irregular respiratory efforts are there, and some flexion of extremities, greenness is there, and body is pink and extremities are blue, we give Apgar score as 1. And when the heart rate is greater than 100, and when baby is having good crying, active motion, we give as crying is there and completely pink, we give the score as 2. And then after checking the Apgar and maintaining the normal respiratory rate and normal Apgar score, then clamping and the ligation of the cord is very essential. So how, see nowadays there is no need for clamping with a thread and this, and there are clamps, cord clamps are available. Just with a cord clamp you can just apply the cord clamp and clip it, so that you can after cutting it can just cutting the umbilical cord, it can secure the blood loss. Then documenting urination and passage of meconium, whether a baby has passed urine or passage of meconium. Then administration of vitamin K is very essential. Within 24 hours after the delivery, after baby injection, vitamin K will be given. Then prophylactic eye care will be given, promoting parent newborn bonding. In order to promote this, you can just place the baby with the side of the mother, nearby the mother. Then quick check is made to detect any gross abnormality. Any congenital abnormalities is there, you have to have a quick check. If at all any abnormalities are there, you can just inform to the pediatrician, or you can just refer the baby to the pediatrician. Then nursing care of patient in second stage of labor. Never leave the patient alone once she has been transferred to the delivery room, because at any time she may deliver or at any time she may go into some complications. Then encourage the patient to rest between contractions and push with contractions. When the mother is not having any contractions, you have to ask her to take rest. When contractions are there, you have to ask the mother to bear down or push down. Then position the patient's legs in the stirrups for the lithotomy position. Prepare the patient's perineum. Monitor the patient's blood pressure and the fetal heart rate every 5 minutes and after each contraction. Here, when the position of the patient is concerned in case of for the delivery of the fetus, so there are various positions like sitting position, squatting position, lithotomy position, lying down position, sometimes knee chest position, or various positions are available. See, in previous days only lithotomy position was advisable for the mothers in labor, but nowadays various positions are there, especially in our Fernandez Institute of Obstetrics, Fernandez Hospital. They are following each position, different positions are followed there. If at all you get a chance, you can go and visit the hospital and know about the different positions they are following for the delivery of the fetus. Next, these are the positions used, like standing with support, squat, then semi-sitting position, and you can ask the mother to bear down due to contractions. Then sitting position, this is sitting on toilet. Then squatting position, supporting. Then side lying position, walking, yes, simply walking may help in relaxation of the muscles and help in early delivery of the fetus. Standing position is there. Then leaning or kneeling forward with support. Then knee chest position. Lithotomy position, this is the usual position that will be adopted for delivery of the fetus. Next, complications during second stage of labor. Sometimes slow progress of labor may be there, or when the baby is in an unusual position like occipito-posterior position or transverse lies there, sometimes there is no progress of labor, and many mother may use some other alternatives for the delivery of the baby or delivery of the fetus like cesarean section. Next, concern about the baby's condition. Chances of perineal tear, chances of postpartum hemorrhage, retained placenta, umbilical cord prolapse. Yesterday, in one of the slides, I've shown you how the cord prolapse takes place. Then umbilical cord compression. So these are the different complications during second stage of labor. Okay, girls. So this is the second stage of labor. And when you come to labor room or dear one, I can explain you and practical. I can show you more. I can give you more information. Okay, girls. If you read 2 times, 3 times, or 4 times, then it will you will understand. So try to read as many times as possible till you understand. And if you don't understand the topic, you can just make a note, and when you come over here, we can have a clear. I can clear your doubts. Okay, guys. So in next session, we will see one more topic.